Good evening. Welcome to our November council session. I'd like to welcome those in attendance tonight, students from Milton Union. I would also like to thank our council members for being here and participating. At this time, I'd like to invite everyone to stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. And immediately following the pledge, remain standing and I will pray. So.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. And to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Let's pray. Father God, we come before you this evening humble and blessed as Americans. God, we recognize Veterans Day yesterday, and I'm sure all of us are very thankful for those that have served in the past and that are serving now, and those that will serve in the future. And God, we just pray that you'll just protect those that are serving now and keep them safe from harm, and also for their family members that are away at this time. And God, we're just such a blessed nation, and we have so many things to be thankful and grateful for this month. God, we recognize our duties here as citizens in this town, and that we would just do those things that we need to do faithfully and do it to the best that we can do. God, we just ask you just bless this evening and just bless those that are here. And God, we're just thankful for our citizens who support this town and support this council. It's in your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. This meeting is now in order. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Mayor Cote.
Here.
Francis.
Here.
Miller.
Here.
Tennerman.
Here.
Fogel.
Here.
Ashley.
Here.
And Willis.
Here.
Thank you. The following certificate of the clerk of the council to the presiding officer of the council of the municipality of West Milton was read. The undersigned certified that all requirements to notice and notification has been done or attempted to be done in compliance with Council Rule 3, signed Linda Cantrell, November 12th. Before we continue on with our meeting this evening, I would like to take a brief moment to share some thoughts to our community. First, I would like to thank the voters of West Milton for all their support in re-electing me as the mayor. I feel there are very few things of higher honor than to be chosen by your neighbors and your community to represent them in elected office. I promise I will work hard and serve with integrity. I would also like to take this opportunity to congratulate Councilwoman Susan Willis in being elected to her third term on council. And congratulations to Anthony Miller being elected to his first term to council. I look forward to continuing to work close with council and our manager in the coming years as we tackle some very important issues. And on behalf of council and the administration, we would all like to thank the voters of West Milton for their support in the passage of the street levy. Working for the public trust is something each of us take very seriously, and we cannot thank you enough for your understanding and commitment to our wonderful community. Thank you. All of you should have received your minutes for the council meeting of October. For October, I'd like to make a motion to adopt those minutes as written.
So moved.
Second.
Any discussion to add to those minutes? Okay. Roll call, please.
Francis?
Yes.
Miller?
Yes.
Tennerman?
Yes.
Fogel?
Yes.
Ashley?
Yes.
Willis?
Yes.
And Mayor Cote?
Yes. The minutes have been approved. You also have received your workshop minutes for October. I'd like to make a motion to adopt those minutes as written.
So moved.
Any discussion regarding the workshop minutes? Okay. Roll call, please.
Francis?
Yes.
Miller?
Yes.
Tenorman?
Yes.
Fogel?
Yes.
Ashley?
Yes.
Willis?
Yes.
And Mayor Cote?
Yes. Those minutes have been approved. Mr. Manager, do you have any correspondences for council?
Not this evening.
Okay, thank you. At this time, I'd like to welcome any comments regarding tonight's legislation. At this time, we'll turn our attention to our business. At this moment, we'll look at CM-1326, an ordinance to establish enterprise debt service fund. Mr. Sells?
Mr. Mayor, thank you.
Thank you.
Ordinance CM-13-26, an ordinance authorizing the municipality of West Milton, Ohio to create an enterprise debt service fund and to establish the necessary fees to place into the fund to service the debt created by the water meter replacement project. Whereas the municipality of West Milton, Ohio has, through prior action by its council, voted unanimously to purchase new water meters and replace the existing outdated water meters. And whereas council for the municipality of West Milton, Ohio has further authorized the municipality of West Milton to borrow the necessary funds to finance the purchase of the new water meters, which the municipality believes will provide better service, accountability, and benefits to its citizens. And whereas the municipality of West Milton, Ohio is required to address as part of the major project the issues of cost and how to deliver the best service to its customers based upon a properly administered budget and a fair assessment of the fees. And whereas the municipality of West Milton, Ohio, through its council, has elected to establish specific fees to service the meter replacement project. And whereas, as part of the fee to established by the municipality, it is further necessary to create a specific enterprise debt service fund to properly administer these fees. Now, therefore, be it ordained by the council for the municipality of West Milton, Ohio, as follows, that section 1, to service the debt associated with the water meter replacement project, council hereby establishes the following fee schedule, which fee schedule shall continue during the period of the debt service, after which the fees established herein shall terminate. The fees shall be set as follows. The meter size for 5/8 inch meters, $2.85 per month. 1/2 inch meters, $5.90 per month.
That's one to two inch meters, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, 1 to 2 inch meters, $5.90 per month. 3 inch plus meters, $19.60 per month. Section 2, council hereby further establishes the utility meter replacement debt service fund. This fund, into which the fees shall be transferred, shall service the water meter replacement project debt. Section 3, the utility meter replacement debt service fund shall be created prior to January 1st, 2014, and the fees established herein shall be assessed beginning January 2014. Section 4, the fees established herein shall be fixed fees and shall not be altered except by further ordinance initiated by council. Section 5, this ordinance shall be effective on and after the earliest date permitted by law.
Thank you, Mr. Sells. That would be the first reading of that ordinance. At this time, we'll move on to CM-1327, ordinance to amend water and sewer regulations. And this is also a first reading of this ordinance.
Mr. Mayor, ordinance CM-13-27. An ordinance amending chapters 51 and 52 of the West Milton Code of Ordinances, Sewer and Water Regulations. Whereas it is the goal of the Council of the Municipality of West Milton, Ohio to operate the utility divisions in the most efficient and effective manner, and whereas certain changes to the rules and regulations of both the sewer and water divisions are necessary to achieve this goal, now therefore be it ordained by the Council of the Municipality of West Milton, Ohio, as follows. Section 1, Chapter 51, Sewer Rules and Regulations are hereby amended to reflect specific changes as attached hereto. Section 2, Chapter 52, Water Rules and Regulations are hereby amended to reflect specific changes which are attached hereto. Section 3, this ordinance shall take full force and effect from and after the earliest period allowed by law.
Thank you, Mr. Sells. Mr. Klein?
Mr. Mayor, there's been a couple questions in part of the rules and regulations that are being changed so everyone can have an understanding, is that with the water meter replacement, will be, and I will go that into more detail on the arrearage in my report, but one of the things that these water rules and regs does fix, and I believe a lot of the landlords will be happy about this, is that they won't be set, we're not setting ourselves up for large debts that will be walked away from. And what I mean by that is, essentially, if you use water next May, you'll get a bill June 1st for that usage of that water. It'll be due June 15th. If you do not pay it on June 15th, then you'll get your 10% assessments, you know, in addition. And then you will get what's called, and you'll have your water usage for then June. You will then get a bill in July. On July 1st, that bill will be for that past usage of May, and also for your usage in June. It will be due on July 15th. That one will actually become a delinquent bill. It'll clearly state on the bill that it's delinquent. If you do not pay that bill by July 15th, then you will be shut off. And then the rules and regs also require that you will need to make 100% full payment to be able to get turned back on, instead of what's right now currently a minimum payment that most people seem to exercise. So that will get everyone caught up. It'll be a better cash flow. But we've talked with a lot of landlords, and they're very happy with these new changes in the rules and regs, because we've had several people that rent, they get a high bill, they'll maybe make some minimum payments, but then they'll walk away. So hopefully, trying to make that clear. I think there was a little bit of confusion, probably from my point of view, that I wasn't explaining it properly at the last workshop. Because when I was talking about it'll be shut off after the 15th, I didn't mean that first month. I meant that everyone would get a second notice, which is actually their second bill, but it'll clearly mark on it delinquent.
Thank you. We'll turn our attention to CM-1318. Mr. Sells?
1328. Thank you, Mayor. Ordinance CM-13-28. An ordinance to appropriate funds necessary for the various departments and offices of the Municipality of West Milton, Ohio for the year 2014. Now, therefore, be it ordained by the Council of the Municipality of West Milton, Ohio, that Section 1, to provide for the current expenses and other expenditures of the Municipality of West Milton during the fiscal year beginning January 1st, 2014 and ending December 31st, 2014, the following sums shall be and are hereby set aside and appropriated as follows. How this works is I'll read the fund title and then the appropriated dollars. General fund, $1,862,084. Cemetery fund, $500. Street levy fund, $93,000. Park fund, $42,700. Street construction and maintenance fund, $290,275. State highway fund, $19,000. Enforcement and education fund, $500. Drug law enforcement fund, $500. The OPWC debt service fund, $31,948.66. Water capital improvement fund, $394,651. Sewer capital improvement fund, $412,306. Utility meter replacement debt service fund, $34,053.50. Sidewalk curb and gutter fund, $4,000. Water fund, $772,894. Sewer fund, $421,206. The total of all appropriations, total of all funds, $4,379,618.16. Section 2. The Director of Finance is hereby authorized to draw warrants on the Village Treasury for payments from any of the foregoing appropriations upon receiving proper certificates and vouchers, therefore approved by the board or officers authorized by law to approve the same, or an ordinance or resolution of council to make the expenditure, provided that no warrant shall be drawn or paid for salaries or wages except to persons employed by authority of and in accordance with law or ordinance.
Thank you, Mr. Sells. That is the first reading of this ordinance. And finally, we have a resolution, CM-1329. And Mr. Sells?
Mr. Baer. Resolution 13, CM-13-29. A resolution supporting the use of the Local Government Innovation Trust Fund for planning purposes in coordination with Sinclair Community College and collaborating parties. Whereas Sinclair Community College in Dayton, Ohio is making an application for local government innovation grant funds to the State of Ohio Development Services Agency. Whereas said funds would be used to conduct a feasibility study to determine the need for and to plan a new training program for firefighters, fire chiefs, and fire apparatus mechanics in Southwest Ohio regarding the operation, maintenance, and repair of emergency apparatus and equipment to be delivered by Sinclair Community College, which would be available for all fire agencies in that region. And whereas the anticipated eventual outcome of the feasibility study will be a training program that will result in increases to a fire department's equipment and apparatus reliability, decreases in equipment and apparatus downtime, enhanced regional cooperation and interoperability for mutual aid agreements, and enhancements to firefighter safety prevention of injuries. And whereas Sinclair Community College, with the assistance of partners, will be responsible for the completion of this feasibility study. Whereas the Municipality of Westmoreland, Ohio desires to work in collaboration with Sinclair Community College in support of this feasibility study. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Council of West Milton, Ohio, that Section 1, the Municipality of West Milton does hereby pledge its support for and collaboration with Sinclair Community College in obtaining local government innovation grant funds from the State of Ohio to determine the need for and plan a new training program for firefighters, fire chiefs, and fire apparatus mechanics in Southwest Ohio regarding the operation, maintenance, and repair of emergency apparatus and equipment. Section 2, the Municipality of West Milton does hereby encourage the State of Ohio Development Services Agency to approve the grant application submitted by Sinclair Community College for this feasibility study. Section 3, the Municipality of West Milton is hereby directed to send a certified copy of this resolution to Rob Chambers, Chair of the Sinclair Community College Fire Science Technology Program, 444 West 3rd Street, Dayton, Ohio, 45402. Section 4, this resolution shall become effective immediately upon its passage.
Thank you, Mr. Sells. Mr. Klein.
If it's any questions, I really maybe Ben could give just a brief outline as to what this resolution is.
Sinclair Community College, we actually send our firefighters there. They do not have to have level one, level two certifications. However, 99% of our firefighters that have been on for 15 years or less have a minimum of a level one certification, level two being career. We do have several that actually are career level. They're making us old guys look dumb, basically. But I have worked with Sinclair for decades, I guess you could say. A good friend of mine works there. He's the director of their fire science training program as far as the firefighter training. He called and said that he heard I had had some free time that I wanted to give up. And of course, I laughed. And but anyway, Taylor Watkins is his name, and he oversees the training program. And our guys come back really prepared. I've seen them go to other courses, and I've seen them go to Sinclair. I know the instructors at Sinclair. They're just the best in the region. And I might be biased, but a lot of them are my friends and colleagues. So this would be a very good thing for actually our area, because we could have, potentially, if they get the grant and start this program up, we could have, you know, our future generation could be going to these courses, you know. So it's a good opportunity for them. And it's an honor for us, as in West Milton and myself, to be on the advisory board and committee, because frankly, I think we're the only fire department in Miami County that was actually invited to participate, aside from Ohio Fire Chiefs Association and that sort of thing. So I guess I threw my hat in the ring to help Taylor out. We take some stuff over there occasionally. They give us free training. It's a give and take type relationship, and I was more than willing to help out. And I thank you guys for entertaining the motion.
Thank you. I'd like to make a motion to adopt this resolution.
So moved.
Second.
Council, have any discussion regarding this resolution?
Francis?
Roll call, please.
Sorry. Yes.
Miller?
Yes.
Tenorman?
Yes.
Fogel?
Yes.
Ashley?
Yes.
Willis?
Yes.
And Mayor Cope?
Yes. This resolution has been passed. And we'll move on for the much anticipated manager's report.
I don't know how anticipated it is. Actually, I do have quite a bit of a report tonight, since last month was more of a special meeting for Bill J. First, I would like to say that it's my understanding, and I'm probably going to mess this up a little bit, but the way I was explained to me this evening, Time Warner Cable is switching from analog to digital, all of their programming. And that includes Channel 5 WMPA. So as of tonight, or today, I guess it started, we are no longer currently on Channel 5 as it sits today. We are on channel 99.1 on your digital dial. Now we're on tonight, if you have my understanding is if you have a digital television, you need to go to 99.1. Once they get all of the programming switched from analog to digital, Tom believes we're actually going to go back to channel 5. So I apologize for any of the viewers tonight that are looking at a screen that just is blank. Tom does this on the internet and on our website, etc., for those that want to see it. Hopefully, there's been some communication. I'm a Time Warner customer, and I do not honestly remember seeing anything of announcements. We got an announcement here at City Hall, but I didn't see any announcement at home. So hopefully there's one or two viewers that might be watching us tonight digitally. So that's what's going on, but I'm assuming we're gonna start receiving phone calls, and I'm assuming you all are gonna start receiving phone calls. So from my understanding, I'm not a techno guy, but by going from analog to digital, it frees up a lot more space on their lines. On their fiber, and allows them to create more programming. The way Tom explained it, it takes this much to take an analog picture through the lines, and only takes this much to get that same picture digitally through the lines. So that was technical terms. That was high tech there.
I was just saying earlier that mine went to channel 5 went off, and I got the letter today.
Oh. Okay,
yeah,
I may have gotten it today. I just didn't pick up my mail today, so
that's
yeah.
A lot of notice.
It was with surprise and sadness that we recently lost a member of the planning board with the passing of Mr. Ed Keller. Mr. Keller also served the village with distinction on several other boards as well, including the Board of Adjustment and the Personnel Board. Our thoughts and prayers go out to his wife and family. He was a good man, and we thank him for his service to our community. I would like to put forth for council's consideration the following names for appointments. Janine Cooper of 10 Stony Ridge Court. You may recognize Janine's name as she served last year on the West Milton Records Commission. I would like to recommend Ms. Cooper for the Planning Board and also the Personnel Board. The Planning Board appointment would be through December of 2014. The Personnel Board appointment would be through December 2016. The other name that I would bring forth to Council's consideration tonight is Deb Miller of 59 Donna Jane Court, and also currently four seats to my left. Deb's obviously most recently a member of our Village Council. I would like to recommend Ms. Miller for the Personnel Board. This Personnel Board is a three-member body that meets whenever there may be an issue arising which involves any decisions made by the manager regarding personnel. It's not met since I've been here, but it's also come to my attention that we do not have one. So I would like to make that fully appointed. The recommendation for this appointment for Councilwoman Miller would obviously begin January of 2014, as a sitting council person could not serve on this board. I do have another name of an individual who has expressed interest in wanting to become involved. I have reached out to him and have yet to hear back confirmation. He had expressed interest, but I wanted to get one last confirmation before tonight's meeting. Therefore, I hope in December, I'll talk to him before the next meeting, and in December I will bring that name forth for a Board of Adjustments, and also the Board of Adjustment as well. So
would you like us to make a motion?
If you make a motion, but I believe you should probably take both of them separately.
Yeah, because they're different dates of service. I think we could do Janine Cooper for both of her appointments. Are they the same term or different terms?
They're different terms.
I think we should do each one of them separately then. Okay. Janine Cooper's recommendation to be on the Personnel Board, and then separately for her being on the Planning Board.
I'd like to make a motion to appoint Janine Cooper to be on the Planning Board through December of 2014.
I'll second that.
Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Francis?
Yes.
Miller?
Yes.
Tinnerman?
Yes.
Fogle?
Yes.
Ashley?
Yes.
Willis?
Yes.
And Mayor Cope?
Yes. Janine Cooper has been accepted to the Personnel Board.
That was the Planning Board.
Planning Board. With Planning Board first. I'm sorry. All right. I'd like to make a motion to for Janine Cooper to serve on the Personnel Board through December 2016. Discussion? No. Roll call, please.
Francis?
Yes.
Miller?
Yes.
Tinnerman?
Yes.
Fogle?
Yes.
Ashley?
Yes.
Willis?
Yes.
And Mayor Cope?
Yes. Janine Cooper has been accepted for the Personnel Board through December 2016.
I'd like to make a motion to have Deb Miller on the Personnel Board through starting January 2014 through December 2016.
Roll call, please.
Francis?
Yes.
Miller?
Abstain.
Tinnerman?
Yes.
Fogle?
Yes.
Ashley?
Yes.
Willis?
Yes.
And Mayor Cope?
Yes. And Deb Miller has been accepted to be a part of the Personnel Board through December 2014.
You could do that famous quote, I think it was, once go out, they pull me back in. Forget what movie that is. As the mayor had indicated, congratulations to the mayor and congratulations to Councilwoman Willis and also Councilman-elect Miller. Because there was a municipal election, it's just a reminder that our first meeting for the new term, starting in January of 2014, our charter states, and correct me if I'm wrong, but our charter states that it's the organizational meeting, or first meeting, is always the first Tuesday after the 1st of January. That would make our first meeting in January, January 7th at 7:30. So it's really just a reminder, letting everyone know. That's the only meeting that it falls on the first Tuesday instead of the second Tuesday. So mark your calendars appropriately. I'd also like to echo the mayor's comments of thanks to the voters of West Milton for the success of the street levy. I do a weekly memo, and council would just bear with me. There's one thing that I wrote last Friday about the street levy to council and those residents that do receive my memo. And that is, first off, thank you so much to the voters of West Milton. But I also gave what I believe was an interpretation of the vote. And my interpretation in their acceptance to the levy is that they not only appreciate our efforts, but that there's an expectation associated with their vote. An expectation which we will continue to provide high level of service, or as Ben and I would like to say, excellence in public service. And that we will always work for what is best for the community as a whole. I know each of us take that responsibility seriously, and we are committed to them just as they have expressed their commitment to us. I'd also like to have everyone mark your calendars. I just found this out this afternoon. Please mark your calendars if you have the chance for this Saturday, the 16th. At 10 o'clock in the morning, there will be a grand opening ribbon cutting ceremony for one of our newest businesses in downtown West Milton. It will be called Bakes, Bibles, Ball Cards, and Bulldogs. It's Reverend Kerry Baker has opened up or is opening up a shop. You may have noticed it being spruced up and ready to go. Reverend Baker came in this afternoon to talk about it, invited me and wanted to invite all of council to come to his shop or to come to his store. He's told me that he has two prominent Bulldogs or two prominent Milton Union graduates who are going to be giving the honor of cutting the ribbon. I know one of them is the one that we honored last month. But he would like to invite everybody to come. He's very excited. He has West Milton in his heart, and his nickname is for Kerry Baker is Bake, so that's where it came up with Bakes, Bibles, Ball Cards, and Bulldogs. So it's going to be a unique store, and I invite everybody to be there on Saturday. Just wanted to give you a couple quick updates. We have signed the paperwork now for the water meters. We have put together the financing. The public should know that the total amount borrowed now from Minster Bank will be $580,000 instead of the six. If you remember, we changed it not to exceed six. We now know it'll only be $580,000. Minster Bank is working with us in that we will be only taking or borrowing on draws when there are payments due. So instead of borrowing the full amount of $580,000 in one shot and starting to pay interest on something like that immediately, we'll be taking it out bits at a time. That'll lessen our interest rates. You know, it saves a few pennies. So we're trying to do everything we can to save money as best as we can. We've had to fill out some paperwork, and I know that the equipment will be ordered here shortly. And then it is the intention of the contractor to meet with a pre-construction meeting by the end of November. Hopefully by the December meeting, I will have a calendar of the proposed timelines of when they feel that they should be able to be done with everything. One of the things that I mentioned that I said I would talk about in my report a little bit is trying to explain to the public how we're going to try to do our billing. And what I mean by that is, let me tell you how we're currently doing it. We bill in what's called the arrears. And what I mean by that is, you got a bill in November that was due on the 15th, and that was for usage, that was for your water usage in September. So you used your water in September, we read, and then you got billed in November. That's how far back we are in what's called the arrears. We need to get everyone caught up so we can get to that example that I recently just gave you, that if the water you use in May, you get billed June 1st for. To be able to do that, over the course of the next 3 to 4 months, and I apologize, I don't have the calendar in front of me, but over the course of the next 3 to 4 months, we will now start reading the meters about every 5 weeks instead of every 4. Now that means that your bill will be slightly higher because it's about 1 week to 10 days more usage for about 3 to 4 billing cycles. What that also means is during that same time, we will be changing out your new meter. But that will also get you caught up with the goal of the water that you use in May, you will be billed on June 1st. So I'm sure we're going to get calls. We're going to try to explain it. If you'll recall, the October billing had a story of Bob and Mary. Bob and Mary will be back in the December bill and trying to explain what we mean by billing in the arrears. Just a reminder that we will have a workshop. We have to have a workshop. I know it's the week of Thanksgiving, and I apologize for that, but we have some other issues that we really need to deal with, and that includes giving you an update as to the I&I study. From my understanding, I haven't been able to see Tim. He's been busy, as well as I have, but we've finally now have a report back from our engineering firm, and the engineering firm will be there on that Tuesday as well. So we will, but I know it's Thanksgiving week, but we really seriously need to have a workshop to continue on. Finally, just two other things. As Ben likes to point out, I have the knack of either taking a small vacation whenever there's going to be a storm. It's a sense that I have that something that is months in planning, and then when I do leave for, you know, only a day or two, he likes to call it a microburst, Matt's microburst, or whatever you call it.
Microburst Matt.
But I have to compliment Ben and the staff. While I was gone, I did try to keep up with what was going on via email, and I did receive a few phone calls. I compliment them and Ben's decision in moving back Halloween to Sunday. I thought it was the right decision, given the set of circumstances. I know that, from my understanding, 98% of the public thanked him and thanked the staff, and were in agreement with everything. So thank you, Ben, for taking that on. I'll give you at least 6 months' notice before the next storm, my vacation. You're welcome. And I also have learned that even Tom from WMPA, they always videotape here at City Hall. He said it really worked out for being on a Sunday because they did over 300 kids came. And it worked out really well because it was a couple days after Halloween and candy was half price, so saved money too. So. But I guess there was over 300 kids that were able to get their costumes on TV. And finally, I know we were probably woke up this morning not real pleasant with how happy with what we saw, all that, like what Ben likes to call white death on the ground. But the leaves are being picked up. Please be patient. We're in the heart of it right now. because of the snow, has made it very wet, which has also made it very heavy. As an example, I think we did around 7 loads today, which would probably, had they been dry and lightweight, probably would have been 12 to 13 loads. So that gives you a comparison what happens when they get wet like that. So we're in the heart of it. We know it. The leaves will get picked up, and hopefully this was just a little bit of a dusting of snow, and hopefully it'll warm up. So please be patient, and thank you.
Thank you. Excuse me. Does council have any old business to discuss this evening?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Yeah, I forgot one other thing. I'm only thinking about Thanksgiving and Halloween. There's another holiday that hasn't come to mind yet, although you should be reminded that the TV commercials all seem to go that way all of a sudden. Friday, November 22nd, that is the week of the traditional week of our business open houses in downtown. That Friday, November 22nd, there will be a tree lighting ceremony at 7 p.m. The mayor and council will be there to light the tree. It will be a community tree. It will be at the new parking lot in downtown. We've been coordinating with the downtown businesses. I believe Santa will be arriving. And I believe that the West Milton Fire Department has made arrangements to make sure of his safe passage to downtown. So please be there a few minutes early. You will see the tree go up that week, and mayor and council will have the opportunity to light the first community Christmas tree. Friday, November 22nd at 7 o'clock.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr.
Fogle? I just wanted to make one point as well. I think that in reference to the street levy passing last week, it was attributed to the council members and to Matt and administration for putting together the fact sheet. We really worked hard at that to get the communication out to everyone and why we needed that replacement street levy. And, you know, we handed it out during the homecoming football game parade, got that out to folks, and we also had the open houses where we were able to go out and talk to the community. So it was a good effort as well on our part to get out and communicate things to the community. So I appreciate everybody stepping up to the plate and doing that as well.
The ones that, excuse me, to the ones that showed up, right? There you go, thank you.
Any new business council like to discuss this evening? At this time, I welcome any comments from those in attendance. All right. At this time, I'd like to entertain a motion to adjourn. All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
This meeting's adjourned. Thank you.